Tunes. He couldn't play piano, so he taught himself how to play, but he could only play in like F sharp. So he had so he had a special some kind of special contraption that could transpose his stuff if he needed it. But he wrote like 1,500 tunes, and you know, among them like White Christmas, Blue Skies, Alexander's Ragtime Band, Putting on the Ritz, No Business Like Show Business, and lots of others. People like George Gershwin and Jerome Kern, also great Americana songwriters, American songbook writers, they credited Berlin, Irving Berlin, as kind of the guy that started the whole thing, and they owed it to him. So, anyway.
I would never have thought he wrote that piece of music.
What's that?
I would never have thought he wrote that piece of music.
It sounds so modern to me, but he probably wrote it in the 30s or something. Now we're going to do a tune called The Gentle Rain, and this is by Luiz Bonfá. And he wrote the music, he was a Brazilian composer and guitarist, and he wrote the music for a wonderful film called Black Orpheus, or he wrote some of the music for that, including the famous one, Manhã de Carnaval, and then also Samba de Orfeu. This is not from the movie, this is called The Gentle Rain. I think that you got one, Russell.
Yeah. Let's just start on a vamp on G. So here we go. One, two, three.
I knew that phone was going to ring, so I had to stop it. The feeling I had.
Technical. We're back. We're back now.
Sorry, yeah, it swung. And we're back. One, two, three.
Sidekick character from Scooby-Doo, Scrappy-Doo. So, thank you very much.
I didn't know all this, did you? This next tune is a beautiful number by Victor Young. I heard it when I discovered the piano player Bill Evans, and a friend of mine told me about Bill Evans, and I started listening to this tape cassette back in the days when we had cassette tapes, and falling asleep to listening to Bill Evans live at the Village Vanguard with his classic trio with Scott Farrow and Paul Motion. Anyway, and it just blew me away. They did this one on that particular recording. My Foolish Heart. And also, you may notice there's Valentine's Day is coming up. There's a little bit of a theme going on here tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
Esther, you want to sing Moon River? Film. Christy Mound, singing. Russell Gores on vocal and guitar. Brett Ingram on drums and shaker. And whatever else I got. And Jules Auger on bass. I was going to say Jules Verne, I think that wasn't right.
That's what I was thinking too.
Steve Cleveland. And we'll play one more, and then we'll have Harry get up, if he would, and tell us a story.
It involves time travel.
Great. All right. This also involves time travel. It's called Nostalgia in Times Square. So this is by Charles Mingus, who's a pioneering musician, bass player, band leader. He came up playing with bebop guys, Dizzy Gillespie and Charlie Parker. Formed his own band, and he idolized Duke Ellington, and anyway, he created a whole bunch of very influential body of music, and this is called Nostalgia in Times Square.
Thank you. Can everyone hear me? All right. So today's story has to do, first of all, with a wonderful family trying to beat the heat. And they build a pool, excavate it out, and all of a sudden, the water begins to boil like a KFC deep fryer. And they realize that they had built it on top of King Nebuchadnezzar's old furnace. Now, the Babylonians were pretty good engineers, but the one thing Daniel can attest to is that their furnaces were built so well that they could continue thousands of years in the future. And so that's where I get hired. I am a time traveling lawyer. Now, in order to break time and space and death, you have to be very careful, you have to be very considerate, you have to be very loud. You tape up 500 megaphones with duct tape. Attach 8 F-18 Super Hornet fighter jet engine turbines, and you yell as loud as you can, "King Nebuchadnezzar, my client demands 100,000 liters of water and full financial compensation." And out of the void comes a deed, and it says, go collect at this bank. Well, I walked to this bank, expecting to find a few gold bars and ton of water, and I find a hole in the ground, and then I realize, oh yeah, in the 3,000 years it's been sacked and pillaged by the Vikings, the Goths, the Parthians, the Romans, so I have to go get a time machine. And anyway, I scurry into the time machine, and it starts shaking and rattling and turning every color of the rainbow up and down, back and forth, and as I pop out, I realize that the best way to win them over is flattery. So I yell, "Mrs. Belshazzar, whose mighty monthly red flow could drown 10,000 Parthenian archers." I then realize that I accidentally had the BC and AD time switch broken. And there was a very angry Queen Victoria. And she punched me so hard that I broke the space-time continuum. And I ended up in a church very much like this. Except in this reality, Atlantis had never sank, and the dinosaurs never went extinct. So I came to see a giant choir of plesiosaurs, leopleurodon, and duckling campiodonts all singing "This Little Light of Mine" while underwater. Godspeed, captains. And remember, if you hire a time-traveling lawyer, there's always a little switch that says BC and AD. Make sure they have it on the right setting.
What did I miss? Y'all look stunned.
All right. You ready for another vocal?
Oh, yeah.
Russell's going to sing another one.
Yeah, I got this one from the Nat Cole Trio. Just love the way he does everything. Especially this one. This one's called "I Don't Know Why, I Just Do." Are you ready? So I'll play the melody through, or play something through.
Okay. Right.
One, two, three. Thank you.
only time you hold me is when we're dancing so high. You know why I love you like I do. I don't know why I just do.
Thank you. Thank you. There's been a call for an encore. I've heard it.
I like it.
Do you want to take the gold ring? We can do that.
Oh, sure.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. We're going to do an encore.
Yeah.
I
think so. Yeah.
Blue than F. Yeah. Basically, place it. She's an F.
This is a tune written by Duke Ellington for John Coltrane for the record that they made together. It's called Take the Coltrane. A pun on Take the A-Train, which was associated with Duke Ellington.
Later, Take the Soul Train. But that was one. Yeah.
What'd you say?
Nothing.
Thank you.